Everyone says steelhead take 1,000 casts. I hope we can do better than that. But today we're on brandy water. We're chasing steelhead, so fingers crossed. I don't know, I feel like that drift right there would be impossible on a traditional fly line. I'm probably casting 25, 30 feet across this riffle, and I'm able to get it into that soft pocket, and it's just going nice and slow through it. So I'm able to lift my line up off the water. Oh, that's a beautiful drift. Remembered, I haven't taken a water temp. Let's see where we're at. I'm gonna guess 44. 42.8. Not close, not bad, not bad. Good guess. Oh really? Nice. Well, not nice, but you fooled them at least. Get some split shot added on. All right, we're way down river, checking out somewhere new. A lot of private property here, so we kind of have to look for public access. Pushing this really deep hole, pulling some split shot to get my flies down. I'm trying to shot back on top. That might look like a small PMD. I saw some mayflies coming off. Got it in there. In the whirlpool. Well, we put on the squirmy wormy, because, you know, that's supposed to be like a Hail Mary. Tried pretty much everything in my arsenal. I know I'm getting great drifts. Like, this is so awesome that I can lift the line off the water and the currents between me and my indicator are not getting affected. I love this mono rig, but I don't know if the steelhead are not where I'm looking. I did see one rise and we fished in that spot, but who knows? I think they say that steelheading is an obsession. It requires 1,000 casts to get one, and I am starting to believe that that's true. So I've done a lot of casting today and not much cooking. The deep holes, I've gone low and slow. I've gone soft seams against soft water against the seam. I'm looking for buckets here in this riffle. It's like in other streams, this riffle right here would be yanking fish out left and right. Not this one, it seems. Is it like size 40 pound mono? I'm gonna cut it.
I just want my wall right here.
It's a heavy line.
You want it?
Yeah. I'm gonna put it right here. So it's ready to go. Oh no, it won't come out now. Damn it, freaking barbs. Most likely a rock, but it wasn't really where it should have been. Eat it. Well, like I said, we're getting lots of casting practice. Is that pretty deep over there?
Yeah.
At least, like, you know, if one of us is doing well and one's not, there's something to learn from that. I don't know if I've learned anything today. I thought maybe we get into the shady section, they might act differently. I've tried big flies, I've tried little ones, I've tried natural, I've tried attractors. Freaking even threw on a squirmy. A stick.
Well, that's not exactly the end of the story this time. See, we fished hard all day. My batteries were extinguished, so I couldn't record anymore, and I was just kind of getting frustrated right as sun was starting to set. And believe it or not, right before we had to go home, we got into the steelhead. I got two of them, baby. The key apparently was to fish later when the sun was off the water. It was almost sunset. I fished really deep. I fished really slow, about 9 feet under the Indy. I had a sexy waltz worm on the point. I had a thread Frenchie on the dropper, and they both took the sexy waltz worm, a size 14, believe it or not. A sexy waltz worm, I know, right? Whew, it was super exhilarating. They were fun to catch. Had Jeremy there to help me net them, which probably would have made it a lot harder to get them in the net myself because they really like to run. I mean, they were jumping in the air, they were rip and drag, it was super exhilarating. And while Jeremy didn't get one himself, he was super pumped just to see one back in the net, and we cannot wait to get back. So now that my confidence is back, you know I'm going back up to the steelhead water and we're gonna get another one on camera for you guys, so I'm super pumped about that. One more thing before you guys go, if you look down in the description, I've got a link inviting you guys to join me on my Discord server. If you don't know, that's basically a chat room where we can talk fly fishing. We got gear discussions, we're talking about fly time, we're talking tactics, we're talking all things fly fishing. So if you want to join me in there, I'd love to have you guys. I look forward to chatting with you. Until then, everybody, see ya.
Okay, that'll make the blooper reel. Okay. That'll make the blooper reel. Any chance of catching a fish? Zero.
I thought you maybe got a fish.
No.